Alright guys, welcome back, this is Doc M and I'm playing SimCity and finally I finished my experiment here. I wanted to do a comparison. As you can see by now I have $8.3 million. So I've been playing for quite a bit, 180,000 people, and yeah, we achieved what I was thinking might happen. If you compare the traffic down here, where we used a bit of a different tactics, and the traffic up here, it is crazy how it all works. If you look at the workers and shopper situation here, I was able to create basically a complete gridlock. As you can see, we are using avenues as main roads here, where we have houses situated. What? Oh, okay. Hooray, team mayor. And, yep, that is definitely the worst thing you can do. As you can see, I tried to have these three avenues. One, two, three. As kind of yeah, outbound roads, and then have the houses directly settled to next to it. Also, I tried some things out with the land value and created this little pocket here of high value buildings. We'll probably leave those here. That is not a big deal. But up here, this section of the city is completely useless with the avenues as the main roads of living and transportation. You have to use side roads. And I wanted to see if that would really gridlock the city, and it basically happened. Most of the public services are suffering a lot because they cannot get through anymore, pick up trash, fire service problems, police, it all comes with traffic. Look at that, we got 4 a.m. so it's definitely not rush hour, and there's a complete gridlock in the city. I made sure to nicely balance out shops and living quarters, but still everybody feels the urge to commute down here for shopping and all kinds of things, for work as well. Some of them need to commute over here, as we have our advanced coal mine in the meantime, and here the trade port with a minecart track. I almost said the rail track. In here we got the smelting factory, here we got the ore mine, so that is all working, but I want to completely remodel all of that. I also was testing some things with public transportation. Right here we have a streetcar depot, and I made a streetcar line basically running from down here up and into the main streets here, trying to gather people, you know, who want to travel down and pick them up with streetcars. It didn't ease the traffic at all. Then I tried to introduce buses. Where is my bus depot? Here, normal shuttle buses. We should use double-decker buses, but I just wanted to see how those react, and introduced some bus stops around the city that also didn't ease the traffic, logically, because the traffic is basically destroyed. We have this gridlock, and thus not even buses can move, and the effect of buses, you know, taking up passengers and moving them around, won't do anything. We have, although we have a lot of buses, you know, a lot of people are riding with them. If you look at the streetcars as well, we got 5,800 riders a day with a 12-minute average waiting time. That is pretty good. Still, a lot of people prefer taking their cars. You can see another fire here, and the fire trucks are stuck in traffic, can't do nothing, house will burn down. So, let's do some remodeling. First of all, we need to rip out some stuff. Streetcar depot, done. Shuttle bus depot, gone. We need to D-zone, first of all. Now we're gonna try to build that up. You, I'll control you. You can I think we've controlled you. You can unzone areas nicely. Control you. Okay. At least check this. All needs to be unzoned, and we gotta all rip it out, including the ore mine and everything. And we're gonna try to establish it here. I try to see if I put in some more crossroads and give them alternative routes, if that would ease the traffic a bit, but not at all. So traffic needs to be routed in a proper way, kind of like we did down here, but there's other alternatives for routing traffic, and I want to try that out and see if we can get an improvement. Yeah, so money wise I'm rich. You see how the public transport did cost us? No, I ripped out those two things, and already we are in the plus again, although we're just destroying things. So yeah, public transport very expensive, and if the traffic situation already is messed up, oh yeah, Nissan Leaf charging station, that's some kind of an add-on, some kind of electrical cars you can put down. So yeah, if the traffic is already messed up, you will not be able to fix it with public transportation. If you have the gridlock, you have it, and you need to do something against it. Yeah, strip out this small fountain park. Okay, put it all out. Of course now we are losing money because we have blown up public services. Smelting factory will stay, that will stay. I think we will leave the smelting factory, that is alright here. We could leave that, but we will reposition the ore mine. And now let's rip that all out. No zones left, okay. Rip that all out. Actually, you don't have to delete houses right yet. If you rip out the streets, everything will be gone. Okay. Cannot, it's burning at the moment. Let's rip that out, rip that out. Streetcar stop, yeah, yeah, yeah. Can all be gone. Okay. Also, streetcar avenues are quite bad because, yeah, traffic cannot pass over the streetcar lines. It makes it even worse. So we're gonna downgrade this complete avenue here for now again and get rid of the streetcar stuff. So downgrading is for free as it is a downgrade, but it will of course cost money again when you wanna upgrade it to a streetcar eventually, but I'm not quite sure what high-density avenue. Yeah, that's what we want. High-density avenue, high-density avenue. High-density avenue, high-density avenue, high-density avenue. Okay, I think... Okay, now we got this road here. What do we have here? Iron. Okay, let's try to destroy that. Let's try to clean up properly. Control, you can select bigger chunks of street, get rid of them if you want to. Okay, up here, this thing is still burning. Gridlock in front of the smelting factory, like a crap load of people can potentially work there, and it shows. Okay, let's get rid of that. Okay, but now we can also get rid of that. Okay, so we kind of have this main road here. This leads into the city, this leads to the power plant and all these things. This is an abandoned house, and it should be alright in here. We have a little transition road that can also stay. It's not bad, and here we got the main road basically. So now We wanna have some workers, you know, for all this stuff and here. But we don't want them to commute down. Oh, there's some stuff. We don't want them to commute down into our city. So now let's look at our budget real quick. It's super blown up. City specialization is costing us, education is costing us, waste disposal is costing us, but not too bad. Those things are actually not super bad. You can see the adjusted tax rates here a bit. Okay, but still, we're losing a lot. Now we need to generate income. Those specialization buildings are costly. So, let's try to put up a little settlement up here. And first of all, we're gonna use this high density avenue, and we can cut it back a bit, just a little bit. Now we're gonna see dirt roads just to plan out a bit here. Okay, high density street, gonna have the main road in the middle. Okay, high density avenue straight, and that's 90 degree. Wait, I think we need a helper street up there so we can see better. We have a 90 degree. Okay, let's go and see. Think should be all right. Yeah. Okay. T junctions. You want to use T junctions. You don't want to use full junctions like here. They massively hinder traffic flow. As you can see here, the commuters from the smelting factory are really going nuts. Actually, we could shut that down for now. Could also shut down the advanced coal mine, which is also costing us quite a bit and will cause us traffic issues. For now, we want the people to keep on working in their jobs down here. Okay, so we got one of that now. Now we can try to have side roads and align the buildings on the side roads. So we should upgrade that thing here. High density street. And continue that like that. And here we're gonna have some junctions in here. Okay, there's the railway track and go like this. Okay, and we're gonna could offset it, but we're gonna try the normal junction setup here. It's not like a gigantic area. We're gonna go until here. Yep, let's just upgrade this. Okay, and let's keep on going. That. Here, here. Could probably even have streets here. No, it interferes a bit. Okay, it's all right. And now we're gonna try to set it up kind of smart again. First of all, we wanna give them some jobs. So let's align that here. And we're gonna give residential there. And always make sure, you know, facing each other. So these lines are taken now. So now we would put in commercial again here. Whoops, we don't want to zone the side of the thing. We don't want buildings to pop up here on the main street, on the traffic lane. Here and here. Okay. Very classic layout here, and I'm gonna speed up time and we're gonna observe the zone a bit, and I'll be back in a short while. We made some progress here. This unbelievable. As soon as we made this new area, Godzilla decides to show up. Stupid thing. We're having a bit of garbage here. I saw Godzilla showing up a few times in the meantime. When he had this bigger city. Now having some trouble collecting the garbage because of the crazy traffic. And thus the Godzilla shows up. So the traffic is the key to freaking everything. What will he do? He'll take out the trade depot? Will he? Partially, okay. The advanced coal mine? Completely. Thank you. And the wind power plant, the additional one I installed, well, that can go anyways. And yeah, why not take out the recycling center? Great. Okay, let's see. Yep, took it out. And did he destroy parts of the power plant as well? Yes, he did. Okay, now he reached his destination. Let's fix this here. Just need to make sure we produce enough energy. Okay, that's good enough. Now, recycling station. Are we done yet here? Finally. Recycling. And also put the recycling station here or here on the main service roads. So we actually reach both areas. Yeah, I think I will put the recycling center down here. Funny thing is also when you have these metal HQs and stuff, you can actually close them down and save money, you know, don't really have to have them running. They cost quite a bit. If you take them out, you save on money. Okay, energy is back up and running. Did he destroy anything on the garbage dump? No. Doesn't look like it. Good. Okay, here our advanced coal mine was taken out. We don't have to replace it right away. Let's look at that. Yeah. It's a bigger chunk of coal here, and there's some iron, so we will rebuild it a bit over there. No problem. Just need the traffic to flow in. Okay, here we also need to fix things. Yeah, that is destroyed. Okay. Okay. If you have one of these things, you basically don't need one of them. So let's reconfigure. We can save a bit of money. Bunch of coal gone, but yeah, we're not too concerned about money. Okay, here with the trade port. Alloys, so mixed metals, that is normal metal, freight, and as we have a recycling center, we should also add plastics, and we should also add, do we have alloy already? Alloy, yeah. Should be okay for now. We can allow trading with everything. Export, export, export. So a bit of additional money, and we're gonna. Oops. Get our recycling plant. So we have a plastic reclamation line. And we're gonna use an alloy reclamation line. Alloy is not the same thing than aluminium. And it's important, kind of important to know. just in general. Plastic, metal, yeah. Gonna use all reclamation lines. Okay. So, that is that. We have a bit of traffic jam down here. But yeah, there's a lot of dynamic in the city right now. And we need to wait a bit and see this place up there develop. Let's quickly have a look at the job situation. Mm-hmm. We're bringing down the unfilled jobs. That is also a goal of mine. At the moment, you know, if you have the big coal mines and stuff running, you will have a crap lot of commuters trying to fill in the unfilled jobs in there right now. It's okay. We're kind of, you know, not having so much access. All right. So I'll let this part of the city develop and I'll be back. Okay, guys, just a little progress report. The area up there is developing nicely. First houses are popping up. And I planted down a second police precinct. We have a lot of criminals. Not really crimes are committed, but people got unemployed from closing down the shops. Although, we have unfilled jobs. So, still, a few got unemployed, turned into criminals. You can see that here. Can't find work. And they will go unemployed and eventually go criminal. So, we got a few in the city, but it's getting a bit better already. You can see crime is high in these regions here. But, yeah, got another French police station there now. And also, I wanted to try out Maxis. So Maxis is out on a mission right now. Okay, save the injured. Can send him on missions and patrols. I accepted that one, that he's looking for injured Sims here. And yeah, he's trying to save him. And then you can unlock further things. Maybe we can fight Dr. Wu a bit, just for the fun of it. Definitely want to try it out. And it's so annoying. You hear the constant freaking police signal. Crime has the upper hand. Crime has the upper hand. Where? Why? Say something. Yeah. It's all cool. We have some problems with people going to school. We have 953 students which are not enrolled, and that is a bit weird. Not quite sure why that is so right now. Let's have a quick look at the education map. Yeah, over there. Those are the criminals, yeah. Why are they not enrolled? There is school bus stops, as you can see. They're kind of refusing to go to school. Yeah, this is this uneducated area. There's quite a bunch of criminals. It's the mafia. Let's keep track of the school buses a little bit. Speed up time, see what they do. Okay. Seems for some reason we have a hard time picking up these students here. That's pretty weird. Okay, now we have a bit more enrolled. Yeah, there's kids waiting at the school bus stops. Okay. 44 kids. This is all potential criminals. We need to get them off into school. Yeah, now it's looking better. Still a few unrolled here, but most of them. I wonder what prevents them from going to school here. We might try to have another school bus stop here. Okay, it's on the other side of the street here, just to try. Okay, but that should be okay now. Fighting crime with education is normally the best way. Right now, we have to invest quite some cash in police. Oh, come on. Save the injured. Injuries treated one. Okay. Maybe we can do it. We want to achieve the next level with him here. They're upgrading. Let's have a quick look at potential upgrade time. Yeah, next up the shops here will go up. And we have a nice little microcosmos up there again. Sweet. I'll be back. Alright guys, I've been waiting a little bit and also laying out this road here. And yeah, we are having a evenly matched balance at the moment, but we're making profit from sales, from the recycling centers. And yeah, the balance in the city is pretty well. Only 3,000 unfilled jobs in total, which is pretty cool. There's an industrial demand, of course, in the city. We should fulfill that now. And one thing that still bugs me out a bit, the criminal situation is kind of constantly a problem. It's a bit better in these areas now, and if you look at education, we have everybody enrolled by now. So hopefully that will in the long run get rid of the crime problem again. I don't know where it came from. Maybe there was a power outage for a certain amount of time. Also, of course, if you bulldoze police stations, the criminals get released into your city and move into the closest buildings. And we had the police station on a different spot. I moved it. It made the criminals move out and hang out here. Do we have a... Oh, that needs some fixing here. Streetcars blocked in like crazy. Hiding in here. There we go. Okay. Oh, there was a serious issue there. And traffic situation is brilliant. Again, we have a lot of people walking, as you can see. Walking along here. Also commuting within this area. And now let's have a quick look. And this is the ore, this is where we can get ore, so right here, and coal is right there. So I was thinking I would put the coal factory on this corner, mining, advanced coal mine, 250 tons, yeah, right there, and the ore mine we're gonna put right on there, right on the money, so to speak. Okay, so you can see immediately that creates cost to run these plants, and if you look at the job situation, that should have created 1,700 jobs alone, so it seems to be pretty decent. Okay, we are producing coal, we're producing ore again. So here, we should activate that, and also in the power plant, we should turn that over to, yeah, let's accept some global delivery still. Think we have to have a coal pit here, yeah, okay, let's add a coal pit, we can store that as well. Put it right here. Okay, so now we should be able to handle everything. Here we're getting raw ore. Here we will be getting coal. It is all delivered to here where we produce alloy. And the thing is, we could maximize our income, and we could quickly do that. As there is the global market still disabled in the game, so prices will not change, it would totally make sense always to produce the stuff that makes the much money or the most money. So plastic reclamation line should go, alloy can stay, metal can go. Then we put in more alloy reclamation lines. That gives the biggest profit. We cannot put one here, and it's good enough. And here we're also gonna restructure a bit. Alloy, that is good. Metal furnace, gonna take that out. And we're gonna add another alloy furnace for now. We don't want to overdo it. Okay, so we're gonna produce alloys everywhere now, and yeah, we are storing them here and selling them to the global market. Plastic and all the other stuff, then that doesn't make sense at all, because yeah, the price will never change in the game. And I'd say, you see, thing kicks in. I will observe that now for a little bit, and we can immediately see heavy traffic movement here. Yeah, this is commuters, and we use this road here a lot for our deliveries and so on. And you see a lot of people will now start commuting from down here and there. Let's quickly look on the people movement map. Yeah, you already see. And yeah, that is a bit weird if you ask me. You saw before a lot of people were walking, some do still. But okay, there's our shoppers from where are these shoppers all going? We could call this place downtown here, basically. And this is some kind of a small uptown region, probably. Yeah, just want to see the traffic a bit. See a lot of workers here. How many? 336 579. So yeah, those are the biggest employers now in the city. Having no raw ore at the moment. Yeah. We'll start soon. We might have to up the output a bit here. But yeah, 5.5 tons, it's a bit low. We should up the output a bit. All out with the coal the ore production here, almost all out. Okay, so I'd say I put down a little cut. You can immediately see these things cost you money, but yeah, you will hopefully make a lot of money from selling the goods you produce from them. I want to try out an optimization for traffic flow, because right now we have a big congestion here. We want to keep this road as clear as possible for delivery trucks. So I knocked out the commercial zone back there. We don't want to touch this road here, but we want to have a high density avenue, and we want to kind of put it back here. Let's see, maybe we can put in a curved road connection. All right. That looks a bit wonky. Let's go like this, and also go for a curve connection. Okay, so that will hopefully encourage a lot of traffic to roll on top. Yeah, on the top road now, and alleviate the traffic pressure here, so we can keep this road kind of open for delivery trucks and things going around. So you can see, when you start with the specialization, you'll definitely go in minus with your budget. It is hard to provide enough funding. We could increase the population. Residential demand is rising again, so that is the next expansion, basically. But you see, we are making profit, of course, because of the sales you do. I've seen oil cities, for example, by Hal B. Starcraft. I've been watching some of his videos lately, very, very good videos. He understands the game really good and can explain it nicely. I suggest you check him out if you want to. And yeah, he made an oil city, for example. He was losing 31,000 an hour, but he had like, I don't know, 20 oil refineries going. Really crazy. It's pretty cool. And he was also making a lot of money by doing that. And yeah, he's a pro in the game, so he understands it. So if you want to get some more in-depth stuff, trying to learn as well, give you this information, but he's already really good. Okay, guys, we are basically sitting on maximum density. Let's have a quick look. Almost maximum or maxed out density here. Here, buildings under construction. Happiness here is also alright-ish. Here, there's a little bit of an issue. I was observing the traffic a little bit. And, yeah, it's doing pretty well. The road we slept in here helps a lot. Many people from this area now take this road, and it was well worth sacrificing a few of the shopping buildings here or commercial buildings. The ratio now is better. Now we got about a 4-to-3 ratio, 5-to-2 would also be all right. Depends on the density a bit. Those buildings are also making quite some profits, and yeah, no shoppers at the moment, but they're providing jobs. 5 a.m. I want to quickly kind of watch the rush hour with you guys before we end this episode for today. Now there's a bit of issues. We hopefully will be able... this abandoned. We hopefully will be able to record the board meeting. Karelli's wifey has birthday, and yeah, there's some issues. Hopefully we can figure it out. If not, we might go without a board meeting this week. We will see. Oh yeah, and now the traffic starts to flow. Can see this road here pretty empty still. You can see some movement in the city, and we can see that the workers, because yeah, that's why we made the settlement up here, are pretty much taking this road up here and keeping our delivery lines free, and also not really massively clogging up this road, because most of the people that work down here, as you can see, kind of stick to their place. You know, we managed to balance it out fairly nicely. You can see lots of workers in these buildings here, and there's a few commuters coming in now, also some of them working up here, it seems. You can see that. So we might have to add a little bit more of commercial down here to keep all them down in their area, and those people will be able to work up here. You can see residential demand now is maxed out again, as we reached kind of maximum density almost in all the living areas here. So yeah, we can expand further. Need to carefully think about it, so we keep the traffic intact in our city. And as you can see, we're almost breaking even already. Maybe if the last few houses here up in density, we should be able to break even with fairly low tax rates still, 11, 10, 9. We could increase that and probably would be able to already push into the green a bit. But yeah, kind of have, you know, it's a sandbox game, you kind of can set your own goals, and I would love to kind of balance it out with fairly low taxes at around 11% for low wealth residentials, and still have, yeah, the mining stuff going on, which we have at the moment, and have a working city with not so much traffic problems. We see a bunch of moving trucks moving about. We have to wait it out for a little bit until the houses are upgraded, and then we will see the final traffic situation for the city as it lays out right now. But I think we're on a good way, pretty happy, kind of fun to play in a kind of analytical approach, and I think we're on a good way. And I hope you guys like this video. I'm constantly sending this freaking Max Manor out to save some more people. He saved two until we activated this quest, but looks like our medical system works pretty fine. Education is also okay. Hopefully the crime wave will be under control. And that's it for today. Hopefully we get that sorted. Then we should be fine. I'm out. Bye guys. Hit the like. Helps a lot.